by the city of Baltimore to shake up the way it does business. It's now signed on with an outside firm to create a long-term plan on city finances.
And get ready. The mayor says tough choices are ahead. I-Team lead investigative reporter Jane Miller joins us live in the newsroom with the details. Jane.
Donna, this move could lead to big changes. The kind of services residents and visitors get, the benefits city employees and retirees get. That will be the main focus of this effort. Why? Where do you see the size of that number now?
In signing up an outside financial consultant, the mayor says she's looking for a plan to provide real reform, not just of the cost of city services, but of the city's tax rates, a big issue in the recent primary campaign.
Including a path toward lower property taxes.
The consultants will have much to look at. As we reported earlier this month, the city budget has exploded in the past decade. Adjusted for inflation, it grew 26% between 2000 and 2010, 10 times more than inflation-adjusted wages, which grew by 2.4%. A big driver, according to the mayor, the cost of benefits. $171 million this year for pension contributions for city employees, $120 million for employee health benefits, $58 million for health benefits for retirees, $82 million for a prescription drug plan.
That's $80 million spent on pills alone. Employee health care costs continue to grow even as our workforce gets smaller.
Bottom line, at $431 million, the cost of benefits now swamps the cost of services.
Taken together, we spend more on these employee benefits than we do on our entire police department.
The mayor said employees should expect changes in their benefits plans. The public should expect changes in services. A key question, she said, what services can the city live without?
And all options must be considered.
The firm that has been hired to put together this 10-year plan is Public Financial Management out of Philadelphia. The city will pay $460,000 for the firm's work. The firm has worked in many cities around the country, including Washington, D.C., New Orleans, Miami, and Pittsburgh. Reporting live tonight from the newsroom, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.